Hey guys, what's up? I just kind of wanted to take a quick second to talk and apologize for the lack of videos for the past few days. Honestly, I don't want to get into too many details here, but it's not just my job that's been kind of rough on me. These past few months have been really rough, and I don't know, I've just been really kind of down and depressed lately, and just I haven't felt like doing anything. So I just haven't had, I guess, the energy or the willpower to really get up and make a video for you guys. I'm sorry. I just been going through some stuff and just been really down lately. So sorry about the lack of videos. I'm gonna try to pick it up here. I'm trying to keep my mind occupied and my mind busy because I hate being alone, with my own thoughts, because I tend to overthink everything and just dwell on all the bad things. But regardless of that, let's see what happens when we get into the first round of the playoffs versus the Montreal Canadiens. So let's see what happens here. First period. All right, shots are 8-12, 0-0, which is always great. All right, there we go. Kyle Turris and Jonathan Drouin. That's great. Good job, Drouin, and good job, Turris. And there's Bjorkstrand, which I always like to see because, well, he does not tend to produce a whole lot. But I'm happy that he is starting to produce now. All right, come on, boys. Got a 5-on-4 power play. Let's go. Okay, let's see. Come on, boys. Got a minute left. And it looks like whoever is in net, which I think it was Gibson, looks like he got his first shutout of this year's playoffs, which is always great for him. Oh man, look at our offense. It's 100 right now. Oh man, that is great. One second, guys. I just wanted to take a quick look and see, make sure that our power play is set up correctly. I'm actually going to move Bjorkstrand up and Ovechkin down. So there we go. Alrighty. Let's see if that helps us or if that hurts us. Alright, simulate. Yep. Here we go, boys. Game two. First period. Oh yeah, Roman Josi, good job, buddy. All right, so shots are 9-15 right now. We are out shooting them, which is always great. So let's see what happens. Oh yeah, there we go. And there's the rookie. There's Kirk Rollison. That's great. All right, boys. We've only got a 2-goal lead. Heck, that can change very fast. And there's Alexander Ovechkin. So that's great. It seems like this year we are not having as many problems as we were last year trying to solve Carey Price. And there's Zuccarello scoring one on John Gibson, but that's all right. We still have 2 goals, and there's Lance Finger on Carey Price. So there we go. I think that might be his first goal of the playoffs. So good job for him. He's actually our fourth line, so that's very good. I always enjoy whenever all of our lines are producing. All right, boys, here we go. Game number three. Let's see what happens. First period. Oh, yes. Look at that. Lance Finger again, man. That fourth line right winger. Coming in clutch, I'm telling you. There's Jonathan Drouin. There's Alexander Ovechkin. There's Roman Josi. Awesome. Shots are 14-8. So John Gibson is absolutely brick walling them right now. So he is shutting them down, and we are shutting them down defensively, and we are lighting them up offensively. So here we go, boys. Second period. Oh, yes. Robbie Fabbri and Ghost Bear. Alex Galchenyuk and Max Pacioretty scored on us, but we still have a 4-goal lead, which is quite nice, I should say. Shots are 24 to 22 right now. So they are definitely shooting on us just as much as we're shooting on them. I don't know. I guess our defense is a little bit more solid and our goaltending is a little bit better. So come on, boys. Let's see if we can't just shut them down for the rest of this game and take a 6-2 lead. Oh, yeah. And there's Alexander Ovechkin again, just for good measure. Man, 7-2. I want to take a quick look at the three stars. Yep, there's Jonathan Drouin. There's Lance Finger. He's like a 78 overall and he's got 1 goal and 2 assists. Like, what? Alexander Ovechkin, 2 goals, no assists, but 3 hits. Oh man, that's great. That is absolutely perfect, and we take a 3-0 dominant lead on this series. Can we sweep the Montreal Canadiens? I think that this should be game four, so let's see what happens. First period. All right, we only have a one goal lead right now, but that's okay. All right, shots are 8-11. They are out shooting us, and they are going to start the second period with a power play. So let's see what happens. Oh yeah, and there's Bjorkstrand again. They are still out shooting us by about 10 shots. Somehow we still managed to take a 2-0 lead, even though we were being outshot. So let's see what happens in the third period. I mean, anything can happen. I mean, we've seen some pretty crazy stuff. And there's Bjorkstrand's second goal of the night, and there's PK Subban scoring one on John Gibson. And there's Laurent Dauphin, which is always great to see him produce. Because, you know, I mean, he is a 90 overall, but I mean, he keeps on putting up solid numbers. I mean, both in the playoffs and in the regular season. So honestly, I think that trading for Dauphin was a great idea. I definitely like him more on the first line than I have any other center this year. All right, boys, let's see. Yep, there we go, boys. We have swept the Montreal Canadiens. So that is such a big accomplishment. That might be one of the first few teams we've ever actually swept in this playoff or in the playoffs in general. So Abdelkader has no points, has two penalty minutes. He's a plus one. I mean, how many shot he's only gotten four shots on net. Huh. Three face-offs, one. He's only taken three face-offs. Huh. He's got nine hits though, which is great. Yeah. He's number three in hits, right behind Ovechkin and Jenner. So that line is definitely a pretty physical line, which is always what we need. So let's see, which is basically what I wanted Abdelkader for. I don't want him to score a bunch of goals for us. I wanted some solid, gritty players on our team. So there we go. There's Jonathan Drouin. There's Laurent Dauphin. There's Alexander Ovechkin. There's Robbie Fabry, and there's Oliver Bjorkstrand. They all the way up to Landsfinger, they all have a point per game thus far. Landsfinger, I'm very, very, very surprised about. I mean, he is a 79 overall right wing sniper. There's his stats. Holy shit. I just never realized he's got a 92 offensive awareness. Wow. I mean, the rest of his stats, you know, I mean, they're kind of sort of mediocre, but that 92 offensive awareness must be where it's at. Because he's right. I mean, right now he's killing it. That's for sure. Jeremy Bracco with three assists. Eric Dayton with one assist. So that's okay. It's not too bad. Roman Josi, two goals, one assist. Now, the thing I am most curious about, let's check out our goalies. So John Gibson. He's gotten one shutout, and look at that save percentage. 0.968. One goal against average. 120 saves. Holy crap. 0.968. That's probably one of the highest save percentages I've ever seen in this game during the playoffs. That is absolutely ridiculous. So, all right, boys. Let's see who we're going to be playing next. If I had to guess, it's probably going to be Boston. But let's find out real quick. Come on, hurry up. Come on. There we go. Yep. So it looks like we're going to be facing Boston. Let's take another quick look at the playoff tree just because I want to see how many games it took Boston to beat. Okay, well, they swept the Maple Leafs. Okay, then. Yeah, they absolutely swept the Maple Leafs. And it looks like Carolina beat Buffalo. I really hope that Carolina can beat Columbus because, God, I'm so tired of facing Columbus. And Columbus swept the Penguins. So it looks like Dallas beat St. Louis. Chicago beat Winnipeg. Vancouver beat San Jose. And I cannot believe that. Colorado swept the Edmonton Oilers. What? Okay, I did not see that one coming, boys. That's insane. But alright, boys, so it looks like in our next video we're going to be playing or facing the Buff. I almost said Buffalo Sabres. The Boston Bruins. So, I wonder where what it's going to be like. I mean, they are number one. They're right above us. We've got one more win than we do, or we have one more win than they do, but they have a few more overtime losses than we do. So, I don't know, boys. This could be the toughest series yet. So, thank you guys for watching, and once again, I'm sorry about the lack of videos here lately. I've been feeling like shit. I mean, just it seems like everything just kind of goes wrong all at once, you know? And just piles on, I guess. But sorry, I don't mean to try to vent to you guys, but you know, it's just been difficult lately. So I hope that you guys are doing better than I am. And if anybody ever wants to talk to me or needs to vent, I'm always here to listen. So just hit me up on Twitter or hit me up on YouTube or whatever. So until next time, boys, I'll catch y'all later.